Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the class. In this session, we will see how to value goodwill using capitalization method. In the previous classes, we had seen how to compute goodwill using average profit method, super profit method, and annuity method. And in this session, we will see calculation of goodwill under capitalization method. Myself, Dr. A. Devi, Assistant Professor, Department of Commerce, KCS Kazinadar College of Arts and Science. Under capitalization method, the super profit is to be computed using capitalization of average profit and capitalization of super profit. The formulas under capitalization of average profit method is goodwill is equal to capitalized value of firm minus net asset. And capitalized value of asset is nothing but adjusted or actual profit divided by normal rate of return. And the net asset is the difference between the total asset and external liability. So, while taking the total asset, it must exclude goodwill, and after taking that asset, external liabilities is to be excluded for finding net asset. And under super profit method, the formula for finding goodwill is super profit divided by normal rate of return. So, with this formula, we will see how to value goodwill under capitalization method with a practicing problem. Capitalization method, like we had seen average profit and super profit, and capitalization of average profit is nothing but under this method the value of goodwill is calculated by deducting the actual capital employed from the capitalized value of average profit on the basis of normal rate of return. So goodwill is to be computed by normal capital minus actual capital employed. And normal capital or capitalized average profit is equal to average profit into 100 divided by normal rate of return, nothing but average profit divided by normal rate of return. And actual capital employed is to be computed by deducting our external liability from the total asset. So we can call it as a net asset as actual capital employed. And the capitalization of super profit, this we have already seen. The formula for finding goodwill is super profit divided by normal rate of return. Problem number 1. A firm earns rupees 120,000 as its annual profits, the rate of normal rate being 10%. The assets of the firm amounted to rupees 1,440,000 and liabilities rupees 4,80,000. Find the value of goodwill by capitalization method. So under capitalization method, the formula for goodwill is capitalized value of firm minus net asset, for which we need two values. One is capitalized value of firm and the other one is net asset. And we know the formula for these two also. The formula for finding capitalized value of firm is actual or adjusted profit divided by normal rate of return, and both are given in the question itself. The firm earns rupees 120,000 as its annual profit. This is nothing but an actual profit. So take actual profit 120,000 and divide it with normal rate of return. The normal rate of return is also given in the question, that is of 10%. By dividing this, now we have a value of firm. The value of firm is 12 lakh. So this, as these values being calculated using the capital utilized in the business, this is called a capitalized value of the firm. So why do you have this formula? 10% is a profit. The profit amount is 120,000. If it is the profit amount is 120,000, this means this is 10 portion. Then how much is 100%? So that it will be of capital invested into the business is nothing but capitalized value. So don't get confused with the formulas, because when we know the formulas by its meaning, then it will be easy for us to recollect. So here we need a capital value of a firm. So for how much is being invested, for which the company gets 10% as a profit, if the 10% is 1,20,000, then 100% is 12 lakh. So this is how the capital value of the firm is to be computed. Then net asset, here the meaning of net asset is total asset is to be excluded with deducted with the external liability. So while taking the total asset, if it is inclusive of goodwill, the goodwill is to be excluded. But no information is given in this problem. So 1,440,000 is a total asset, and external liability, as they have given only a liability, we should treat this as an external liability. 4,80,000. By deducting this external liability from total asset, we are getting net asset, that is of 9,60,000. The goodwill is the difference between the capitalized value and the net asset. It comes 2,40,000. Hence, under this method, the value of goodwill is 2,40,000. Question number 2. The following information is given. Capital employed is given. Net profits for 5 years are given. Profit included non-recurring profit on an average basis of rupees 2000. So they said that this average profit, this annual profit is inclusive of non-recurring profits. Out of which it was deemed that even non-recurring profits had a tendency of appearing at the rate of rupees 1400 per annum. Actually, the non-recurring profit is 2000, but they have a practice of showing it as 1400. Hence, the difference between 2000 and 1400 is to be adjusted from the annual profit. And the information of normal rate of return is given. You are required to calculate the value of goodwill as per capitalization of super profit method. Here we must be notice the question which has been asked. Here they are asking you to find the goodwill under capitalization of super profit method. The formula for finding goodwill is super profit divided by normal rate of return. In this problem, we have normal rate of return, that is of 10%. But we don't know what is super profit. And to find super profit, we have a formulas and we had seen in the last classes how to compute super profit, for which the super profit is the difference between the adjusted average profit and normal profit. And we don't know the adjusted average profit, that is to be computed with the 5 years annual profit. And we don't know the normal profit, and the formula for finding normal profit is capital employed into normal rate of return. Normal capital employed is 3 lakh, normal rate of return is 10%, and hence normal profit is 30,000. And average profit is to be computed like this. Add all the annual profits of 5 years, it comes 1,64,000. And to find average profit, total profit is to be divided with number of years, it comes 32,800. And in this, so we have to adjust the non-recurring income. See, the non-recurring income is 2000, whereas the 1400 has already been considered. Hence, the difference is to be adjusted in the average profit, and this will become our adjusted average profit, 32,200. The difference between adjusted average profit and the normal profit will be the super profit. The formula is super profit, that is 2200 divided by normal rate of return. 22,000 is a goodwill for this question. Yes, move on to the next question. Question number 3. The following is the balance sheet of Alpha Company Limited, and balance sheet is given. Here on the liability side and the assets are given. The company commenced operations in 2004 with a paid up capital of 2,50,000. The profit earned before providing taxation have been as follows. So the 5 years annual profit are given, and you may assume that income tax rate is 50% has been payable on these profits. The average dividend paid by a company for 4 years is 10%, which is taken as reasonable return expected on the capital invested in the business. So the normal rate of return is to be considered as 10%. You are required to ascertain value of goodwill of the company. So in this question, we have to find the average profit, and hence we have to move on with the method capitalization of goodwill under capitalization of average profit, for which we need an average profit, adjusted average profit. Number 2, we need an net tangible asset, and we need capitalized value of business so that we can find the goodwill. So all these 3 notes is to be find out. And then finally, we have to apply the value into the formula of goodwill. First step, we will find tangible asset. To find the net tangible asset, we know we have to take a total asset. But total asset should not include the goodwill. So exclude the goodwill amount of 25,000 from the total. The total asset is 4,75,000. So from 4,75,000, deduct goodwill of 25,000, it comes 4,50,000. The goodwill which is given in the book. Actually, they have already shown some value of goodwill in the books of accounts, that is of 25,000. Now we are going to calculate the market value of goodwill, so it is to be excluded. After excluding this 25,000, the total asset comes 4,50,000, from which external liabilities is to be deducted. The given question is consisting of bank overdraft, sundry creditors, provision for taxation as an external liability. So that is to be deducted, and this is a net tangible asset. The next step, we will find an adjusted average profit. Add annual profits of all 5 years and find the average profit. It comes 71,900. Deduct tax from that profit, then adjusted average profit will come as 35,950. Capitalized, the third step, we will find a capitalized value of a firm. Capitalized value of firm is equal to adjusted average profit divided by normal rate of return. Adjusted average profit is 35,950. Normal rate of return is 10%, and hence the capitalized value of firm is 359,500. So the goodwill is to be computed by deducting net asset from the capitalized value of firm. So actually the value of firm is 359,500 and the net asset is 281,650 only. The company is having only 281,650 as an asset, but the value comes as 359,500, and the difference is because of goodwill. So the difference is goodwill. Value of goodwill is 77,850. Thank you for listening the class. I hope you understood how to compute goodwill under capitalization of firm method. Thank you.